Good afternoon, and welcome back to Asgard, and welcome back to Sky Factory 3. Since last episode, of course, I was fairly busy the last couple days with Qantas, I'll go ahead and say, so I haven't got as much done on here as I was wanting. I did get all of our Inferium crops up to Prudent level, and I started building off on the back here, back in here, there he is. I knew there was a log chicken in here somewhere. Building out this little area, which we'll end up expanding this and moving things, but basically today, of course, I wanted to start the chickens mod because I feel like right now we have sieving pretty well set. I'm happy with sieving for the time being. We'll end up expanding it later on once we have access to steel, but for the time being it's fairly good. I mean, I've got a bit of stuff built up. I will say this got backed up because I forgot to add a quartz enriched iron drawer. So it did get backed up and it wasn't able to run while I was offline as much as I was hoping, but we are good on resources. That's not really a concern. But today I want to start working on chickens, and I will say that after this I've been doing some concept sketches for the actual base that we're going to start building out. Oh, by the way, these crops over here are wood. I started throwing them down. I didn't know what else to move into next as far as tier 1 stuff went, so I was like, well, we'll get wood. Wood and nature, I think, are the next two. But anyways, that's just wood essence. But I did start drawing up some sketches earlier and coming up because I have an idea in my head what I want to build. And so we're going to start working on that fairly soon. This keeps chucking stuff out every once in a while. I'm still trying to get it all caught up because it got so backed up. You'll notice that, and this just, it's not cooking fast enough. So I'm hoping that these will maybe stop running for too long. So, but now that I have all the drawers in place, it shouldn't happen again. I apologize. But anyways, before we get into chickens, there is one thing that I want to really, really quickly do, and that is I want to barely scratch the surface of Actually Additions. And the reason is because, you know, starting Mystical Agriculture was all well and good, but we're getting to the point that manually collecting the stuff and manually, I mean, even with the Tier 2 seeds, the Inferium seeds, I mean, it takes a while to get the essence built up. So what we're going to do today is we are going to set ourselves up a farmer really, really quick. It's really easy to do. We're just going to need an atomic reconstructor. We're going to need a couple pieces of black quartz. It's just nether quartz and coal combined. So now we can get our iron casings. Let's go ahead and grab two because we're going to need them. And then we can get our atomic reconstructor. So the atomic reconstructor, I'm just going to set it up. Yeah, this will be perfect. And we're going to put a lever on this. Flip it to off. And what it's going to do, it's going to allow us to change blocks. So what I want is the farmer, but we're going to need 4 Inori crystal blocks. And these are Inori crystal, or you can just transform iron, which is what we're going to do. So if we grab ourselves 4 blocks of iron, hit the lever, and that's going to allow this to run. You can actually change this redstone mode if you want to. Right now it's set to redstone. Deactivates it, but you can change it so that a redstone pulse activates it. And okay, we've got 2 Inori crystal blocks. For some reason it didn't transform those two. Normally it does like a 3x3 area, or at least it always has, like in my other series and stuff. That's strange. Anyways, now we can get our farmer. It's fairly cheap, and this thing can farm a 9x9 area in front of it, so it's actually very handy auto farmer. And so what I'm thinking is we will make ourselves a nice Inferium crop area to get started. So on this 5th block is where we're going to set up the actual farmer. And let's do something like that for the time being. So this is going to farm basically all the way out to here. It's going to auto farm all of that. And it can still go over like 3 more. I'll add on to it. Right now, I don't need like the huge, massive 9x9 farm, but it definitely does the trick. And by the way, this is just a mechanical user from Extra Utilities 2 with the watering can in there. And it's set to use item on block and just right click. It does speed this up. You can't see it running. If you get speed upgrades in this, I believe you'll be able to see it a little bit more, but you can't actually see it running, but it does speed up the growth quite a bit. Like, I'll harvest this thing, this area here, about 8 times before I harvest this. And that's just using the mechanical user. So it does speed it up quite a bit, which, you know, the speed is handy, but I'd rather just have it auto farm, like, all the time when I'm AFK and stuff. So, I'll take that any day. I'll take it any day. So we'll just set up our crop. For right now, we'll just put it right here. That's fine. It's probably going to stick it all over the place, but then what I want to do is I just want to bring our energy line out, basically just right out of here and connect it up to the farmer. Which I know I'm destroying my walls, but this was just a temporary home, so it comes with the territory. Oh, wow, I had just enough. That's lucky. So anyway, that's going to build up with power, and then what I want to do is I want to bring, let's bring some item conduits out. All right, we're going to go ahead and tell this that it can extract on green, and it can also insert on brown, is what we're going to tell it. And then, let me go make a couple drawers here. We'll set them up like right here, is what we'll do. And what I want to do is I want Inferium Essence to go into one. I want our Dirt Essence to go into another. And I want our Wood Essence to go into this one. And we'll just go ahead and lock them. All right, so we've got our two filters. And then what we can do, let's go ahead actually and snag one of these seeds. We're going to set up a chest right here. And this is basically going to be a buffer chest. And we're going to bring our item conduits over. We're going to say that you insert on green. And then what we're going to do is say that you also extract on brown, always active, but with a filter, and you're going to whitelist our Prudent Inferium seeds, our wood seeds, and our dirt seeds. That's what we're going to do. So only those can get pulled out. And then over here, we're going to put down some other item conduits. We're going to say that these can insert. And then what we're going to do is let's bring this item conduit back. I want to break this connection. Let's see. Where'd my wrench go? We're going to go ahead and break this connection. And we're going to say that you can extract always active. And so now if we were to throw our, and we want to also blacklist before I do that, the dirt seeds, the wood seeds, and the Inferium seeds. Go ahead and blacklist that. And the nice thing is, I mean, these aren't going to produce any more seeds, so we can just throw this stuff into here. It's going to plant it. It's going to go into this inventory, and then there we go. It's planting those seeds for us. And so now basically we can just make, you know, additional whatever seeds, and it's going to plant them. And there we go. We've got a dirt crop. It's grown, and so that's got 8 in there right now. And there we go, it just broke it. Now there's 9 dirt essence, and it's probably, oh, it replanted it right there. But anyways, this will be automatic now, and we won't have to manually do this stuff, because trying to do mystical agriculture and having to manually do it only when you're on the server is, it's rough. So now life has just gotten a whole lot easier. We'll be able to make some real advancements in mystical ag now. So anyways, let's move on into chickens and start working on them a little bit. Just the basics today, I think. But anyways, with this, there's two particular mods that you're going to want to look at. There is the chicken mod. This is where you're going to find all your eggs and stuff. And there's also these hen houses. We're not going to get really into hen houses. Basically, the hen house, if you give it bales of hay, it can harvest, or it can pick up any blocks that chickens drop in like a 9x9. We're not even going to mess with that. We're not interested in that at all. But what we're going to be mainly looking at is the hatchery mod. So you'll notice there's a fair number of blocks here. The first thing that I want is the animal net. It just requires some string and sticks. So we'll go ahead and grab that. And what this is going to allow us to do is, you know, if you've got a golden lasso, it's somewhat similar to that, but it works in conjunction with the chicken mod blocks and the hatchery blocks. What we can do is we can right-click to pick up our animal, and then we can right-click to set it back down. So this way I just kind of want to get our chickens out of this pen so that we can kind of consolidate and see what we have and you know, actually start focusing on the mod in one particular area. I know there's a flint chicken back here, you guys. There we go. Now there's still a few chickens that can spawn naturally in the world that we haven't got. I believe iron, also snowballs, and there's some things like that that we can get. But anyways, if we look at the stats, you'll notice that these are all 1-1-1s, but this one right here is a 2-2-3. Basically, I just bred those chickens one time, those 1-1-1s, and I got this 2-2-3. So it's pretty self-explanatory how to raise the stats of your chickens. If you're familiar at all with AgriCraft, it works the exact same way. But we're going to make a little pen here. We got a 2-2-3 right there, and the only other, I mean, the rest of these are all 1-1-1s. So what we can do is we can take our seeds and we can feed these two. And after a second, we're going to get a baby chicken. So now we have a 3-3-3 baby chicken. So let's go ahead and get rid of this. We don't want a 1-1-1 anymore. No interest in it. So we have a 2-2-3 and a 3-3-3. What we're going to do is let's get rid of a couple of these. We don't want them. So now we have this flint chicken. And this is a log chicken. Why will you not breed? Oh, he's on a breeding cooldown. Whoops. So anyways, now we have to wait for this baby chicken to grow. Now, if we take a look at this, you'll see he has a growing cooldown. Basically, it's going to take like 15 minutes and some odd change for them to be able to, you know, to turn into an adult. But we can feed them seeds and it will cut down the growth cooldown. Now, I will say that it's a diminished returns. After, like, once you get it, like, we just drop by, you know, a few minutes there, and now it's like 1 minute, and you know, we're not getting as much of a change as we continue on. And once you get it down to like a minute, you're only dropping like 5 seconds at a time. So there's a certain point where it's just not it's not reasonable to continue feeding the chicken seeds. But there's some blocks that are going to help us out with that. And once again, like I said, Jay Jones was helping me a bunch with the you know, this mod. There's not a whole lot of information, and he has a really, really crazy setup, which we'll go take a look at shortly. So he did suggest that we get our chickens to a 10-10-10, like the log chickens and the flint chickens and stuff like that. These initial chickens, get them to a 10-10-10 before you start crossbreeding, because the baby chickens are actually going to take on the stats of the adults. So if you have 10-10-10s, all your breeds in the future are going to be 10-10-10s. So you really only have to up those stats initially, and then after that point, we basically just crossbreed, and that's about it. So it will be very, very easy moving forward once we get you know, all of our initial chickens to full 10s. Now, next up, let's talk about a few really, really nice blocks for progressing with the mod and everything. Now, I will say there are some chickens. I still haven't gotten regular chickens, and we need regular chickens to get our die chickens. So basically, if we take a look here at the chicken mod, and so like initially you can get white, yellow, blue, brown, green, red, and black chicken eggs from dyes, and then you can crossbreed those to get all the colors. So I am going to have to get some white chickens. I haven't had any luck as of yet getting those to spawn up. And I don't believe, but there's no way to make a spawn egg, so I'm just kind of, you know, hoping that I get lucky on some of my animal spawns. I'm going to make some more, how did I hop over that? I'm going to make some more areas and stuff and try to focus on getting some white chickens so that we can move forward with the, you know, the whole dyeing process and everything. But anyways, let's take a look at a few very, very useful blocks here. And so the first thing that I want is I want to grab ourselves a nursery monitor. This is fairly easy to craft, basically just requiring a piston. And also he did suggest that we get a good auto farm wheat field set up. So I am going to set up another wheat farm with the farmer block. So just a big 9x9 wheat field, because we're going to be using a lot of seeds moving forward with mystical agriculture and our chickens as well. But anyways, for example, this baby chicken, you know, we want to be able to see it And so we're going to actually remove this. But it's going to zip that baby chicken over and leave the mother. Basically, the feather side corresponds to the adult chicken. Now, this baby chicken, once it becomes an adult, is going to be zipped back over to that pen with the other chicken. So, very, very handy block. So next up, let's get ourselves a nesting pen. And this is fairly easy to craft. It is going to require a hatchery nest, which is hay bales, but oops, there we go. Luckily, I've been stockpiling wheat, so we have plenty of hay. Let's get ourselves a hatchery nest, which we'll get into those later. Basically, those are used for hatching eggs. But we'll get our nesting pen, and the way this works, and actually, in addition to this, let me go ahead and get us a hopper. Actually, I'll tell you what, we're going to go ahead and make ourselves a storage crate. And then what we can do is, if we were to say, set up right over here, we're going to put a storage crate, and then we're going to put a hopper connecting onto that storage crate. And then we can just put our nesting pen right here on top of it. And then what we can do is we can grab one of our chickens, and let's see, is this one done? Oh, it is. Good, good, good. Let's go ahead and breed these. And so now we have a 4-4-4. Awesome. So I'm gonna go ahead and snag this 2-2-3. Honestly, this 1-1-1, I'm just gonna kill it. Don't need it anymore. But this 2-2-3, we'll go ahead and just put it into this nesting pen. And you'll notice it says next drop in 6 minutes and some change. What's gonna happen is whenever this chicken would normally lay like wood and manure and stuff, it's going to automatically go into this hopper and get sent into our storage crate. So now, even when we're offline, this is going to be collecting all of our items for us. So we may as well, I guess, do the same with the flint chicken. I don't know. The flint chicken I'm not as concerned about because we have tons of flint. But I guess we'll do that for right now. Now next up, let's get ourselves a chicken feeder. This requires a block of iron and some slabs and stuff. Not too expensive. And so we'll grab that, and then what we can do is we can actually set this chicken feeder up over here near our baby's pen. And what it's going to do is it's going to, in like a 4x4x1, I believe is what Jay said, it's going to feed those chickens. So we'll set it up like right here. And then what we can do is, you'll notice it says stored seeds, 0 out of 200. We can put seeds into this. I'm gonna do like, yeah, 13 is fine. I'm gonna throw 13 seeds in there. You'll notice now it gets a little graphic there that says there's seeds in it. And what it's going to do is it's gonna feed this chicken. There we go, it just fed it. And the growing cooldown dropped from 11 minutes to 3 minutes. With the use of just a couple seeds. So basically what it's going to do is it's going to feed those babies for us so that it doesn't take like a million years for them to become an adult. And instead we're going to get those adult chickens quite a bit quicker. So very, very nice. Over here, how are you coming along? Next drop in 3 minutes. So the only other thing we have to cover is hatching, which we'll get into that. We don't have any eggs to hatch right this second, so I'm kind of waiting on that. But let's go ahead and jump on over to Jay's house. And like I said, he's been gunning straight for chickens. here we go. This is his chicken barn. And you'll notice like there's a bunch of chickens up here. He's basically got slots for all the chickens, all the different types of chickens. So this is just the upstairs, by the way. If we go downstairs, that's where the majority of the chickens are. And this is dangerous. I'm gonna light this up for him. He may not want the torch there, but I don't want a mob spawning in here and killing his chickens. But anyways, down here, you'll notice that there's like a million chickens. And his are all 10-10-10s. You can't see it right there, but if you take a look, well, not that one. I think that's a fairly new one. He's still working at it. Oh no, he's emptied all of this. These were completely full. Like this is an ender pearl chicken, and this is also an ender pearl. Basically, what was happening, there's a bug with it where these chickens, if a chunk becomes unloaded, these chickens will take damage, and these red ones mean if they get pulled out of there and like put into a pen, they'll instantly die. So just be aware of that. Now, if they're in their pen, they can't die. So if that happens, just don't take them out of there, you know. Like there's a cold chicken. Cool. Oh, and my favorite, let me find it here. Right here. It's the villager chicken. It's amazing. So we're going to be getting, you know, really, really into chickens as well as mystical agriculture. Those two mods, I think, make resource gathering a lot more fun than just sieving. You know, I do like the sieving, and it's kind of necessary with the prosperity shards for mystical agriculture, but basically this is this and the upstairs area is like the amount of chickens that, you know, you have. There's blaze rods right there. There is a ton of them, pretty much for all the different you know, all the different resources and stuff in the game. So I was over here hanging out with him for a bit earlier, and he was kind of showing me around. Like, this is where his babies will go, and they'll get fed and then moved over to the next pen. This is for hatching, which we'll get into once we have some eggs to actually hatch. Yeah, you could see there's like a big jumble here of stuff. And then this was just to, you know, gather some items and stuff from it. But yeah, so like I said, I mean, he helped me out a ton with his chicken tips. Sadly, we'll go over there and say hi to him actually really, really quick. Sadly, he's not recording Sky Factor. He's just playing a bit because he has to go back to work fairly soon. But he has got quite a bit of done as far as his chickens go. But that's Jay Jones. Hi, Jay Jones. And he does have a channel. Like I said, he's going to be returning to work fairly soon. And so he hasn't been recording right now, so. And it looks like our one chicken, I just came back. It looks like our one chicken is done. So let's go ahead and breed these two and see what we get. We got a 4-5-4. So we'll go ahead and get rid of this 3-3-3 and throw them in there. And you'll notice that we have a log chicken egg. It's a 3-3-5. We also got a feather, some chicken manure, and some oak wood. So this stuff is going to, you know, just kind of build up when we're offline. So we're going to be getting, you know, feathers and manure and wood and eggs and stuff like that automatically. Now these eggs, we probably long term, we probably won't hold on to them. We'll probably trash them. You know. Once we reach the point that we don't need anymore, he has a ton of resources coming in with just two of each 10 10 10 chickens. So, but I wanted one of these eggs so that I can show you know, how the hatching process works. So what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to get yourself some redstone lamps. So we've got our redstone lamps, and then of course let's get a lever so that we can turn these on. And then we're going to want ourselves some of those hatching nests. Go ahead and get ourselves some hay bales and some hatching nests. Oh, I'm a little bit shy on the wheat. That's okay. I'll add another one later. And then what we can do is let's set up our redstone lamps just like this. And then we can put our hatchery nests down here beneath that. And so for example, I went ahead and threw that old egg. So we have a 4-4-5 now from this new chicken. And what we can do is if we were to put this into one of these hatching nests, you'll notice that it says it's hatching, but it's 0%, and it's not going up. But if we turn these redstone lamps on, you'll notice that the percent starts going up on that. So after it reaches 100%, of course, the chicken's going to hatch. And that's how we're going to hatch these, you know, these eggs. So once we get, you know, once we get to the point where we have the 10, 10, 10 chickens, we'll get eggs, and we can get additional chickens from that. Actually, this chicken, it has a gain of 5, and it actually just dropped two pieces of wood. So, very, very nice. I will say, though, that if you go to the chicken mod, and let's say you wanted Ardite chickens, you can see that it takes Magma Cream and Blaze Rod, and you have a 17% chance to get it. But I did go ahead and get another nursery monitor, because we are going to set up another little area here. Actually, I just realized this nursery monitor, they can't climb over this anyway. So we don't have to worry too much about that. In fact, but we're going to make another little area here so that we can have some other ones cross or leveling up and everything. So in this case, we're going to do our Flint chicken. We'll start leveling those up. And actually, I forgot, our log chicken hatched. So, we have a 4, what is it? 4, 4, 5. Okay, that's still not better than what we've got, so I'm going to kill it, but that's how the hatchery works. So if you wanted to, you can hatch those chicken eggs and basically just duplicate your chickens for you. So it is a very, very handy tool, though, I must say. But yeah, so I do believe, though, with that, that I'm going to end up the episode, though. So, because I think we've pretty well covered chickens. Next episode, I am going to say that we're going to get into growth crystals with tiny progressions because they're super, super OP for farming. And if we get some of those set up over here, we're going to have tons of essence, like absolute tons of it. So next episode, we'll mess with that just a little bit. Okay, he was saying that he doesn't suggest breeding the XP chickens because it just gives you XP orbs, and but you can't do anything with the orbs, so... so just a heads up on that. He's been doing a lot of chickens, so, but yeah. And, keep in mind that all these, like I was showing you the villager chicken and stuff, they have their own textures. So not all the chickens look like every other chicken. Like, these have like leaf heads. So really, really neat mod. Absolutely amazing. So we're going to be doing a lot of that in the, coming future. So, I hope you guys join me for more of that. And, oh, this one's just about to, I need seeds. And like I said, I'm going to have to get a wheat farm, an automatic wheat farm set up fairly quickly. But anyways, like I said, I'm going to end out the episode there. 687. Wow. Okay. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you have any questions, as always, do let me know. And I'll do my best to answer them for you. And if I can't, I'm sure Jay can. So... you know, feel free to let me know, and, oops, I did not mean to, put you there, but, yeah, so, anyways, I hope you guys join me for next time, and until then, as always, do take care, stay safe, and I hope to see you guys then.